eyes start straining off.
Well, this is gonna be not Chrome. Not gonna be. I'm gonna do it from the beginning of a run, but it's not the beginning. It's one of those things where it's a. They're seeded paths. So each level is determined by your seed, but they're randomish. There are like 29 technically. And so it can get harder and harder in time. Classes you're available to play are random. Let me check that. I'm going to choose Techie because it is clearly the absolute best class, because this shield is the most stupidly broken thing conceivable, because you otherwise healing is difficult. But this just basically gives you infinite health, at the very least you can. But now that I know that it's what I have in 6.0, which means let's see here. I've got the stats that I have available maxed out. Raise these to 100 by sinking money down for playing a game and then playing through unlock your system here. But anyhow, so I'm going to change what perks I can start with. Whatever you want. I'm just playing first. Since I'm playing this techie where I gain a shield based on my maximum energy, the biggest thing I want to get is this right here so that I have a lot more energy. And then I also want to get. It is one that I get damage reduction based off of here. This just means I have a flat 40%, which is way more powerful than the other one that would normally be just 20%. So those are the two biggest things. I have a bunch of excess credits, and it costs more and more. Let's see. So explosive bullets is super valuable, but I have not yet. Well, I'll go ahead and get it. I've got the whatever I want, basically. So, explosive bullets are just super powerful. This makes me move faster, which is pretty cool. Another one here that'll increase a variety of stats. Just look at them all the time. Extra health, that's cool. Damage the enemies around you, they dump. Whenever you're on low difficulties still, this is really cool. It'll kill some of the fast enemies that get near you. Very good. This is also really good on the lower difficulties because it allows you to one shot a lot of stuff. I mean, it's still good. This is neat, but not useful at all in the long run. This is a thing that just happens. You can use that if it's available to do this. That's not very great. This is neat, but it's not useful in second player. This is dangerous, especially if you have explosive ammo. That counts for this, so it'll just drop grenades 30% of the time. It's great! The frag grenades and the shots that come out. This is neat, especially as the techie, it's really, you can exploit that, but doing double damage is not actually as big as it sounds like. This will make me move faster, which is kind of important. Extra health and melee damage, just money. Getting 35% of your health back after each level is amazingly powerful if you're not the techie. This is stupid. 80% chance to heal you fully, but with the healing things, or a 20% chance to hurt you. 30% the boss damage, pretty good. Bullet splitting is insanely powerful with explosive explosive rounds because it gets you two explosive rounds per from the first shot instead of one. But your bullets spread, and that means that if you're using like a sniper rifle type thing, you're not hitting stuff very reliably unless you're close to them. And what's the point? Slows things down, kind of neat. Gets you. This one's really strong, especially if you're doing grenade type stuff, because the enemies really will just walk straight towards the grenades. Manual reload speed increase. This one's super good, but if you haven't unlocked the one that just gives you naturally 100%, that's so that you can, if you have like explosive rounds, you just fire the first, because the first shot is the explosive round, and then the rest are just normal bullets. Well, you just reload after the first shot over and over again, so that you can just keep shooting explosive rounds. I'm not gonna do that right now because it's not, but eventually it's stupid powerful. Reload speed, rate of fire, it's good. This one gives you a bit of money, it's silly. That one isn't as nice as it sounds, just because that winds up getting you like one or two health once in a while. 20% damage reduction, this one's kind of neat, but not unless, it doesn't do as much unless you're an assassin already have some stuff. It's not triggering mines, it's actually really good, but not necessary. Knockback, rate of fire, not a big deal. Enemies mysteriously drop live grenades when they die 20% of the time. That was pretty cool. This is what there is. Health, energy, and speed. So I want that, because now I have even more defenses. This one's really good for making money, because you get, if you're using explosive rounds, you'd think that it always counts, but it doesn't, because it amplifies the damage of your shot, and the explosion does its own separate damage. It'll appear as one number on an enemy, but if they die to the bullet part of it, then it doesn't count. But it does splash damage, of course. Stunning things is insanely valuable, especially if you're using rapid fire weapons, because just the enemies will just be stuck. Getting healed by corpses, haven't used that yet, so I don't know how effective it is. Heal more by healing things. Setting enemies on fire is actually pretty strong. You don't crit rarely, especially at this point. This is, if you really want money, this gives you a ton of it. Last time I used it, I was getting 5,000 per floor, which is pretty substantial, and I'm probably getting more than that now. This one's kind of just, like, defeats the purpose of the manual reload, but they do stack, so if you have both of them, it's pretty good. That one does what it says. This one's really strong. Not getting murdered by your own explosives and not getting murdered by rockets is kind of a big deal. Veteran fire damage is neat. Fire you start lasts longer, not a big deal. Double damage to stun targets is pretty good, but not necessary. This one is basically the only reliable way to heal. So that one, I don't know why you get it. It makes things blow up instantly, I guess, so that if the enemies are on it, you really need to blast stuff. This one's just rate of fire, and it says, and thus damage by 20%, so I kind of wonder if it really also increases damage. I don't really know how this one works, like, especially with Techie. Do you get energy out of it? I don't know. Like, does it work with the one where you get healed by energy? I'm not sure how that's doing. That's just a... anyhow, so I am... I'm in pretty good shape. I've got the credits, I'll just sync them. There's a limit to how many you can have, anyhow, it's based on how many runs you've completed. I can choose what ability to start with, although that's not super important. They do a variety of things, they have their uses. Overall, something like the grenade launcher is really good because it's highly reusable, it doesn't take much energy. The anti-hot grenades are neat because, you know, they're what they are, but they take a stupid amount of energy, so they're not a good idea for Marines tech. Micro-missiles are fine. Blast grenades are pretty cool, because there's no shrapnel, and their radius is monstrous. I guess the thing I'll take is... plasma bursts are pretty good. I'm gonna pick a weapon to start with. I'm using explosive ammo, so it doesn't cooperate with piercing rounds like this, because it only works if the bullet doesn't penetrate. However, this is still a really... But the laser pistol is insane. So I think I'll take the laser pistol here. And I'll start it at not level 0 here. Alright. Well, that's enough talking. Let's get to what the game actually is. Since it's almost 6.0, the difficulty is going to be pretty high. This arrangement, normally, those enemies would just die instantly. No thought. Space pistols are quite strong, so it will allow for a function without having to just spam explosive ammo right now. Over them generally. They're usually boxes. One thing is, you can actually just destroy these boxes without opening them, you get nothing. This contains a weapon, but it'll also upgrade my level from this weapon. Oh yeah, I think I shot this enough. Done. So you can accidentally destroy those whenever you're not meaning to. So this means this is a secret level, a special level for me. There'll be a purple elevator.
Shut up, man.
unlock stuff or get a bit of money. Definitely. Must be behind the river. It does not always happen that way. There's the key master I've just Space is really good. It's pretty accurate. to dodge stuff. Yeah, yellow key, so.
I failed.
Explosive rounds things, so you can get the thing that makes like grenade drops, no, it makes grenades drop from your explosives, but it's like, it's nothing basically, so. Micro missile splash is pretty bad. I have to use a precise stick in this. Have to use keys. Alright, boss 4. Any health, so I don't use the auto dock. Also, didn't spend any energy.
Thank you.
curves instead of the dumb. I really just don't. Reinforcements were gonna come, they're gonna stick around. Turn. Shame, but you know, there's the heavy breakable. So I did not pay any attention to the description. That running machine is probably four as large as low enemy activity. I don't know. I didn't pay any attention. Shotguns with the double that basically are exactly the same. You can do this for a lot of damage. Shotguns are very, very high, suffice to say. I'll stick with this one. If I get an eye on. Weapons are like random-ish. Like, I don't know exactly how it works. Although I can actually hurt by shooting. behind the boss again. Here. Slides. Okay. Top and there. Ion shotgun. DPS is technically lower. This is really valuable. It does extra damage to robots, which is what all of the bosses are. And since it's, you know, it's 30% extra. That's, you know, more than this, more than the 160 DPS difference, or it's close anyhow. But it has the advantage of close around real quick. Generally, I wind up going with an ion shotgun. Special. each. Thank you. Oh, you're right, I already, thanks.
Thank you.
melee, like. And just destroying it.
Thank you.
Special key I got off the first box. Nothing. Up here. Next box. Turn on the turret, why not? It does not. Onward.
We'll be right back.
long-term thing.
Thank you.
Thank you. else.
Sit in my lap.
You gotta come over here. Alright, boss war. It's something. Actually, this is a different boss war than that. I guess that this one can be any boss or something. In this case, it's gonna be three of the first boss. Not a whole lot. Whatever. Need that still.
Thank you.
so it's
we'll be right back.
think a napkin is. There are other ways to show your it makes me feel
Thank you.
This is the last regular level. There's no music. or something, I don't know about. I've never seen another boss by now. I don't think you have a choice. Just stand around. There's motivation to stand around any longer. Goes. Technically, just not kill him. That is a run of the Neon Chrome. Here. get.
Thank you.
the gate here. Oh my goodness. That's neon chrome. I need to do some stuff. That's all for now.